back-to-back Thursday night. First, my second farewell special with big guest stars.
Followed by my special with bigger guest stars.
Benny, Thursday at 8, 7 Central Time.
Hope, Thursday at 9, 8 Central Time.
Hey, do we get paid for this?
Do you see the restriction?
Well, I don't know. May I take off my shirt tie?
Sure, sir.
I haven't worn a tie in 3 years. Actually, I borrowed this from the prop department.
I didn't think that was yours.
Right. I just wanted to kind of break it in before I went there, so to see if it was funny. And I didn't get any laughs from it when I came home. Yeah. So that's not bad.
Where do you head from after the Mason?
I'm going to a place called the Frog and Nightgown. It's a complete departure.
It sounds like a complete departure. Like the Naugahyde room.
That's a normal room.
That's a hitter.
People there with just basics and things like that. But I'm concentrating on the Masonette room. One of the songs that I'm going to sing there that I feel that I thought would work there, especially I'm glad that you mentioned the old New York kind of thing, because the old New York audiences, they're very heavy into nostalgia.
Yeah, that's the big thing.
Yeah. May I do a song, that the kind of song that I would do at that time?
Well, you've broken in a suit here. Why not break in a little nostalgia thing?
Well, it's a very old song. In fact, it's called... it's a very old song. It's the kind of song that I would do there. Could you just give me a kind of a draft, kind of a 1, 2, 3, 4? Yeah. Is this the kind of tempo they would
like? I'd like that. It's perfect tempo.
Kind of easy, like
easy going, style. Yeah. That's it.
I mean, the old kind of Harry Richmond kind of guys that move and let things.
That's it.
I mean, that's my
experience. It's going to be perfect.
You sure?
Yeah, oh, yeah.
Okay. Sounds good so far.
Yeah. A little more of that. That's it.
You mean easy,
life?
Easy.
Yeah, beginning to feel it now. When my sugar walks down the street, all the little birdies go tweet, tweet, tweet. Imagination is so funny. Ooh, it makes a cloudy day sunny. Is that the kind of thing you want to do? Thank you very much. Mr. Little Man, have you got my cane? Would you throw me my cane? Oh, Mr. Little Man. Walking and you know oh, pretty little girl, would you throw me my cane? Come on, sweetheart, just throw me my cane. Just throw me my cane.
Oh, I'm sorry, sir, it's yours, right. They match the shoes.
This song's about 100 years old. And it adds, the kind of song one has to have. 150 years old. Me, I'm talking all about Chevrolet down the ever.
Ow! Wow!
I'm talking about Chevrolet alone and feeling very. When
wait a minute. No, we have to do that again. Hold it. No, we have to do that again. There's no way that can be done with the microphone falling. No, hold it, Doc. I'm sorry. I have to do that again. Why did that thing fall off? The show cost $300,000 to do, and another 30 cents, they could put the rest of the tube on. Right from the top. And me,
and my shadow rolling down the avenue.
Ow! Wow! Better, better, better.
I'm talking all about my shadow, all alone and feeling very.
Now let's see if we get it right.
And when it's, when it's 12 o'clock, we're gonna climb the stairs.
And honey, we ain't never gonna knock. You see, nobody's there.
I'm talking all about shadow, all alone and feeling
feeling.
I can't believe how I'm sweating. Why is it so hot out there?
You're not used to working in a tuxedo, that's
no,
all.
You've turned the heat off.
We'll be right back after a word from McDonald's.
Earn my money with my hands, ain't throwing it away. Working hard to make things better, cause there ain't no other way. McDonald's quarter pounder's what I take. I want the biggest, the greatest, the best hamburger they make.
If you want a sandwich with meat, McDonald's quarter pounder. It's a quarter pound of 100% beef cooked up just right. McDonald's quarter pounder is a sandwich where the meat really takes over.
Helping build my country, building me a life. I'm making breaks for myself and some kids and wife. Take them to McDonald's, quarter pounders are what I take. I want the biggest, the greatest, the best hamburger they make. Because you deserve a break today at McDonald's.
You are your own woman, you know what you want. Hey girl, it's you, girl.
There's a revolution going on. Women are part of it. And so is Playgirl, the new magazine for today's woman. Timely, provocative, feminine. It's you, girl.
Playgirl, it's you, girl.
Playgirl, the magazine for women. Ask for it at your favorite store today. Sister Mary Catherine knows as much about babies as most mothers. Ask her about diapers, and she'll tell you about baby-shaped kindies. The disposable diapers shaped like babies, to fit babies. And Sister knows, better fit means better absorbency, and better protection, and less leaking. Baby-shaped kindies. Better fit is only the beginning.
We are back. Says, where's Marlon? No. What that means.
Vindictive jury.
I have a feeling. Tell me if I'm right. You could like to live about 25 or 30 years as a performer before, because you have that style, you have
I
that feeling of the song and dance man, and
I
that
feel
is kind of all past now.
Sorry, I really feel I missed my era. I hear the stories about the Jolsons and these guys who used to work without a microphone and without
Ted Lewis, Harry Richmond,
television. Right. They had a kind of flair about them. The younger performers today don't get into that. And I have a hunch that's one of the reasons that they don't sustain as long.
Yeah.
The old-timers were not necessarily talented men. They were very limited. But they had one thing going for them. And that's why people like Jimmy Durante can work till they're 80 or 90.
They had great mass communication with an
audience. Well, they immediately get to the audience. You see, the young performers here are kind of self-enclosed. Yeah. And they don't sustain as long. Which also the fact that, I mean, this box here, that television box, reveals so much of truth about a person that you can just have so many tricks. I mean, a guy like Jolson wouldn't last more than 3 or 4 weeks on a television show. It seems that the people with the, like, say, for example, Sammy Davis.
Right.
Here's a man that is as versatile as anyone can want to be in show business, yet he had a variety show, and it lasted 10 weeks. He sings, he dances, he does impressions, where a man like Dean Martin comes along, can sustain for years,
right,
because he is, number one, a person, number right, two, a performer. Where Sammy does so much for you as an entertainer that you believe that's like inhuman, that someone has so much talent, so you don't think of him as a human being.
I think Sammy, in concert or on a nightclub stage, is at his best, and has always been his best there, not to detract from what
exactly
he does on television.
So, but week after week, you cannot just do great things. You see, you're better off being inferior to have your own show, actually.
Yeah.
I mean, in terms of talent, I mean, you don't get up and sing and dance. Your bag is being able to talk to people and bring out the best in them and hope somewhere along the line you have some kind of electricity. But you wouldn't want to get up and do Me and My Shadow, or you wouldn't want to do...
Not like that, I wouldn't.
No. No, but you know what I mean. You can go on night after night. I mean, here, people cannot sustain week after week, but you can go on night after night because there's something about you that's not as aggressive as, say, a person who does everything. You just sit back.
I think there's a compliment in there somewhere, but I don't want to go on a scavenger hunt at this time.
It's
underneath there somewhere.
Jack Benny had the secret. He let other people do it for him.
Yeah.
Whereas... Right, he had all the other 4 or 5 people around doing the thing. But people like Sammy, who has a lot of talent, a guy like Jolson would not sustain.
No.
Eddie Cantor wouldn't sustain.
What you're saying is you can't be too good to be on television.
No, you have to be more human. You have to be like a person. Ed Sullivan can sustain, Lawrence Welk can sustain, because there's certain imperfections there. Like introducing the wrong person.
Well, right back here. Prior to each message.
It's
that kind of stuff.
Good.
Linda, I've made a decision.
Wait, Mark.
It's me or that every night shampoo that's gentle enough to use every night.
You're crazy, Mark.
Linda, my ego just can't handle being turned down every night for a shampoo.
Would you rather I lie?
Yeah, lie to me.
Okay, I'll lie.
Linda, let's just stop and go for a walk, huh?
I can't. I'm going out with another guy.
You're not. You're washing your hair. Linda, tell me you're washing your hair.
I'm washing my hair, Mark.
I knew it.
Every night shampoo. Gentle enough to use every night so your hair looks better every day.
Join the great American Shape Up.
Everyone wants to keep in shape these days, and one way to help is eating right. That's why Weight Watchers fish luncheons and dinners make such good sense. Good nutrition, portion control, and plenty to eat. Tender and delicious because you cook them for the first time. Who says you can't get your money's worth these days?
Join the great American Shape Up and shape up.
Sure, I told you. Now I want to show you. Shake and bake for pork is better than frying. Take 2 1-inch loin pork chops. Fry one, the other, shake, and bake thoroughly, like it says on the package. Now look at the difference. The shake and bake chop is taller, plumper, moist and tender. Shake and bake, it's better than frying.
I'm Stein Erickson, inviting you to Ski Utah, America's most convenient ski state. We have 9 major ski areas located within 1 hour from the airport, convenient ground transportation to get you to the mountains, great accommodations, and lots of room to ski, miles of well-groomed runs and plenty of snow. This year, Ski Utah. We are exciting, we are accessible, and we are ready for you.
A Jack Benny special followed by a Bob Hope special starting Thursday at 8.
George, the PTA's coming tonight.
The PTA? You're going to serve your coffee?
If you joke about my coffee again. But he's right, Mrs. Olson. What can I do?
Maybe all you need is the right coffee. Folgers.
Folgers? They all taste the same.
Oh, no, no. Different coffees taste different. And I think Folgers tastes best.
Why is Folgers different?
It's blended special for extra good taste. George will like it.
What's Mountain Grown?
Oh, Mountain Grown's the richest tasting coffee. Make some.
Okay.
I think I'll have another cup of coffee.
You second on my coffee?
Tastes great. Matter of aroma.
Mwah! See, no trick to making coffee. All you need is the right coffee.
Folgers.
Make your next pot of coffee your best pot of coffee. Taste Mountain Grown Folgers. This week, TV Guide talks to David Carradine of Kung Fu about the series and his philosophy of life. TV Guide. KNBC, Los Angeles.
We are back. My next guest, yes, I agree. My next guest has been lurking around NBC all this week, getting ready for his special, which goes on Thursday, this coming Thursday, January 24th. What can I say? Mr. Bob Hope. Yeah.
You're not doing this badly. Did they bury you? What happened, Daddy?
Yeah, what happened? Nothing much. You look.
You know, I was in Chicago. I was coming from Detroit. I did a thing in Detroit. Friday night, they flew me into Chicago, and I was supposed to get a 12:50 at night here, you know. And they got TWA guy met me and said, "What the hell is that?
Are those stewards?
What is Chicago, Detroit, or TWA? What is it?" How do you like that? Nobody's working, huh? Isn't that wild?
What, have you get hung up there?
Anyway, they said, your plane at L.A. is closed, and we booked you into the Hyatt Regency. Who do you think's playing there? You.
Right.
Myron Cohen.
Right.
Isn't that great? Myron Cohen, I went in to see him, and he was gorgeous. He told all the jokes from 1870 up. Isn't he beautiful? I didn't have time to get down to see you because I didn't land until 12, but I knew you were there, and I knew they probably chased you out of town with a posse or something, didn't
they? Yes, he did.
You were just here 2 days ago.
Marvelous man. He makes me laugh. Does he make you laugh?
Yes, he does.
He makes me laugh. You're beautiful.
Thank you.
You're really beautiful.
You make me laugh.
But I'm a wonderful human being.
Yes, you do.
I didn't know we got to that category yet.
Yes. How could you be where you were? You were just here 2 days ago taping.
I was
then
taping.
You went to Detroit and Chicago and
no,
acting.
I finished Tuesday. And then I went in Thursday. I went in to play this thing for Ford.
Right.
And it called the Guest House, a beautiful thing for alcoholic members of the clergy, you know? I swear. They have them. It's a marvelous thing. They have them all over the country. And, you know, no, I'm serious. It's a
from
big
members
thing.
Of the clergy?
Members
drink?
Of the clergy from
it's
drink.
True.
You know, they give up so much, so they have to do something, you know?
So that is true.
In fact, lately I'm drinking much more. Lately I'm drinking much more. I played that.
Yes.
I'm going back to Detroit, and I'll check with y'all.
That's just a jet lag laugh. That'll be in later this afternoon.
The rabbis included there, too?
Yeah.
You're kidding.
They go for Manischewitz a little bit. Little Manischewitz.
No, that is true. I think the people
no, but it's an interesting
joking.
Thing that they do. Well, you know, Ed. In fact, I used your name in vain. I used your name in vain because they suspected some of the wine was missing in the church till they found out the altar boy was Ed McMahon. And it played good there.
Well, how would you like to be Ed McMahon's priest and have to listen to those confessions for 3 years? You'd be in a home by now.
They have a fella just to clean him up, don't they?
You're sure?
Where, where'd you come from, Santa Anita? What is this?
Oh, come on now.
What is that, a Dick Cavett? Yeah. Yes, sir.
Well, I'm a wonderful human being.
I've never seen this before, but
no,
a button in the back.
That's
terrific.
Well, it's for air conditioning. I thought you'd like it.
Is that your idea, or is that your tailor?
This is that. From the same man that does John's clothes.
Yeah.
Same man, you know. You know our boy.
Yes, I certainly do.
What's his name?
Mr. Gray.
back there.
Right. We don't say who does it, but it's all kind of, you know.
I know who
you don't talk much about it. You're smart, aren't you?
No,
just let that thing. And I got the job for you.
I know that.
You know how'd I get it for you?
Well, you talked to this just the gentleman.
No, I didn't. You came on the Eisenhower Medical Dinner.
That's right.
Eisenhower Medical Center dinner in Waldorf. This guy did such a good job, and the head of Hart Schaffner Mark was sitting there, and they said, how do you, and I'm up there all dressed in my full dress suit, you know, and I got the whole thing going for me. He comes up with his regular clothes and does a thing, and he just introduced Bing and I to do a number, and he was so delightful. Next day, he fell into this little job that'll get him
That's much? Very nice. Well, it's good for my old age.
Well, how about cutting me in? I can use a little, too, you know.
You?
I'd like to have a little bit. Huh? What? You don't think of those things, do you?
Yeah.
There was a whole article in the paper, on the way coming from Chicago, reading about the thing about millionaires in Hollywood, and they listed you as the number one man, and you were denying it.
They're sick. They're sick. They're all drunk. No, they think they can put any kind of figures down. Doc has more money than I have.
If
he sold his horses, he'd have more money than I have. This boy. And Crosby, you know, Crosby, who we can talk about again because he's well again. And he sends me a care package every year.
I didn't know that. Seriously, I know you called
and
him.
I told
the paper.
You.
How's he feeling?
He not only has money, but he's figured a way to take it with him. I know because I saw him buying an asbestos suitcase.
I never move till you're done. You notice that?
I freeze right on those lines. I don't move. We're going to come back. We got a short film clip from outtake from your special, I think. But right now, here is the makeup for a fresh, healthy color. It's new Touch and Glow Sheer Makeup.
Ooh.
Only from Revlon.
You know how good the country feels on your face? How your skin glows with fresh, healthy color? Now you can get that look with a brand new makeup invented by Revlon. New Touch and Glow Sheer, the fresh color liquid makeup. It's got pure Revlon color and a special kind of sheerness. You get that healthy young glow of fresh country color, even if you're a city girl. New Touch and Glow Sheer, the fresh color makeup by Revlon. Beautiful. Let it rain. You're wearing one mascara that won't run. Revlon's Super Rich Mascara. So waterproof, tears won't make it streak. Rain won't make it run. So waterproof, hardly anything can bother these great-looking lashes. Super Rich Mascara goes on thick and beautiful, neat and quick. Stays on looking beautiful no matter what. No smudge, no smear, no streak. Totally waterproof Super Rich Mascara by Revlon. Beautiful. No matter what your husband thinks you do, Mondays are busy. So, who has time to cook fancy? Of course, that means Monday dinner can be pretty blah. Well, here's a fast, easy way to stop the Monday dinner blahs. Banquet Heat and Serve Fried Chicken. Crisp, evenly fried chicken in minutes. Children will be delighted. And your husband will be absolutely transformed. So stop the Monday dinner blahs. Serve Banquet Fried Chicken.
It's in your grocer's freezer.
Washington, D.C., and some advice from people who travel for a living.
The American Express card seems to be the only one I can use everywhere I go.
I don't have any other credit cards. I just use the American Express card. And I've traveled from Maine to Hawaii in it, and it's never been turned down yet.
I don't have a lot of other credit cards. The American Express card is all that I need. When I'm on the road, I live on my American Express card because it's so universally accepted.
Call 800-888-5000 to apply for an American Express card.
We are back.
My warm-up. You didn't do that joke.
We certainly did do that joke. I dropped in the other day when you were taping with Burt Reynolds and Diane Cannon. Who else is on your show Thursday?
Deanna Warwick.
Not bad.
Dionne Warwick. Yeah, you get mixed up with all the Diane's and the things. Yeah.
And
Burt Reynolds, he's going to recreate his the pose he did in the centerfold.
No. Live on?
Yeah, and if he gets an itchy nose, I'll be working in a car wash next week. Hey, you know, I'm using this audience, and I'm glad. You know, I'm going to do my monologue right here after the show.
That's right.
Did you know that?
Tonight.
Did you know that?
They were
They were awfully good for me. I hope they'll be good for you tonight.
Yeah, yeah. Well, you're a wonderful warm-up. And I think that...
Two, three, four.
By the way, we're back... We're back to back with Jack, you know, Benny.
Yeah, Jack's got his
show Thursday night.
Does he precede you?
And he's in his dressing room now. I tried to get in, but I didn't have a dime for the door.
Jack will be on the show tomorrow night, this show.
Yeah, he's coming here, right?
That's right. He'll be here tomorrow night with Mel Blanc.
Right.
His old show.
Oh, radio.
You did a takeoff on Papillon?
Yeah.
On your special
thing.
Is that the thing we're going to see here?
You're going to see it, I think. And you're going to see a lot of pieces of everything. Diane Cannon, who is... on the show.
She's a sweet girl.
Yes, she is. She plays a 12-year-old on the show. That's stretching things a little, isn't it, huh? I didn't say
same
anything.
Thing.
I said one word.
Let's run the film clip. Watch the monitors here in the studio. Here it is. Want to leave this mic open so you can comment? Or...
This is Devil's Island, you know. It ain't Hamburger Hamlet.
It's no Dinah's place either.
How the hell would you know? Were you there?
Hey, this energy crisis is really beginning to hurt. You know Sun City is now a disaster area?
It is.
Well, someone turned off the power prune pitter.
She didn't know.
Yeah, she didn't know. She didn't know.
Bob, do you run your washing machine every morning with a full load?
They didn't show that joke to you?
These are outtakes. You won't see this on the show.
This is the funny stuff. Hang around. You'll see all this on the Carson show.
I don't need any partners.
This one, paper.
Must be a cold deck. I thought I saw the Northern Lights. Well, I'm betting $50. You calling?
It's a little fuzzy, but I'll call.
Are they for me?
Why not? Real he-men can exchange flowers without fear.
Which one of us is Truman?
These are...
You can try them, see?
These are outtakes.
Outtakes, you know? Things you will not see.
No, these are things that we were fooling around with. Our joke, we didn't play in that the finale thing, so I said, I'll give you a line, right, real fast. So I thought that played kind of funny. So which one of us? I think if you said, which one of us Truman Capote, I think it would be better, don't it?
You know, I mentioned once before on your show why you've never done a special of just the outtakes from your various specials. Because how many specials have you done altogether?
John, we have so much stuff, and I think both of you are in them from outtakes over the last 25 years. And I want to do a thing as a benefit, you know, a big benefit for somebody and do... a two-hour thing.
Just take the outtakes, stuff that didn't get on
air. Fantastic stuff, and it's actually funnier than anything you've ever seen. You know, because it's people having fun, because you do ad-lib and clown around. It's great. I think we might be able to sell it. We got it all down in the vault, so if there's anybody would like to have an hour and a half show of outtakes.
How many specials have you done for NBC? Or all together?
I've been on, this is my 24th year, and I've averaged 9 and 10 a year. So,
good heavens.
I don't know, what is it? What?
250, something like that?
I hate to take my shoes off right here. Now, how many is it? 200 what?
265 specials.
265 what?
Specials.
You're kidding. There isn't that much time in the world.
Why would he lie about a thing like that?
It's only once a month. Once a month. You run how many? You run a couple.
I did a couple of them, yeah. But the preparation, when you figure 285 hours, then the preparation for each one is how much?
We have 285 writers. No, it's, you know, we're only on once a month, and they prepare. They go for the last 2 weeks. We talk about it, and then they start writing 2 weeks before, and they get in. It's a little machine we have. As long as you throw in the opium and the marijuana, they get it done all right.
Hey, I asked you about Bing a moment ago because it was in the papers, and you mentioned, I read in the papers, you'd talk with him. He was in the hospital up where Monterey or somewhere?
Yeah, Hillsborough.
And everything is fine, it looks
Everything's
like.
Everything's fine. His wife, Kathy, talked to my wife the other day and said that he's going to be back just as good as ever and doing the things he did before.
So yeah, that's great.
That's great.
You have to sell something? We'll be right back after this word about gentle Excedrin PM, the pain reliever that helps you get a good night's sleep.
Imagine feeling so good in the morning when you had that headache last night. That's gentle Excedrin PM. It relieves the headache and its tension, helps you relax for a good night's sleep. So the next morning you should wake refreshed with no grogginess. Imagine feeling so good in the morning when you had that headache last night. That's gentle Excedrin PM.
You're missing my garage sale.
I'm still waxing.
You wax every week. You're going to drown your furniture.
It's the dust.
Well, use Endust.
Endust?
I'll be right over. Watch. Endust picks up the dust and leaves the old wax looking like new.
It really brightens, and it's faster than waxing. My garage sale.
Endust for between waxings. Faster for you, good for your furniture.
Nobody wants to look at underarm stains, but they're a real problem. You use an antiperspirant and you still get stains. Stains that won't wash up. Well, now there's a new antiperspirant. The first anti-stain antiperspirant by RightGuard. A new powder so effective, it helps stop wetness and stains. See for yourself. New RightGuard Powder Dry Antiperspirant. It's the first anti-stain antiperspirant by RightGuard.
Simple diarrhea can come from food bacteria, virus germs, strange water, impurities that irritate your digestive system. Left untreated, diarrhea makes you feel weak, wrung out. Why suffer? Kaopectate checks diarrhea. Many doctors recommend it. Watch Kaopectate's main ingredient adsorb impurities like it adsorbs impurities in your digestive system. Kaopectate absorbs impurities as it checks diarrhea.